The concept of humans doing more than one thing at a time has been studied by psychologists since the 1920s. But the term multitasking didn't arrive on the scene until the 1960s. It was used to describe computers, not people. Back then, 10 megahertz was apparently so mind-bogglingly fast that a whole new word was needed to describe a computer's ability to quickly perform many tasks. In retrospect, they probably made a poor choice, for the expression multitasking is inherently deceptive. Multitasking is about multiple tasks alternately sharing one resource, the CPU. But in time, the context was flipped, and it became interpreted to mean multiple tasks being done simultaneously by one resource, that is, a person. It was a clever turn of phrase that's misleading, for even computers can process only one piece of code at a time. When they multitask, they switch back and forth, alternating their attention until both tasks are done. The speed with which computers tackle multiple tasks feeds the illusion that everything happens at the same time. So comparing computers to humans can be confusing. People can actually do two or more things at once, such as walk and talk or chew gum and read a map. But like computers, what we can't do is focus on two things at once. Our attention bounces back and forth. This is fine for computers, but it has serious repercussions in humans. Two airliners are cleared to land on the same runway. A patient is given the wrong medicine. A toddler is left unattended in the bathtub. What all these potential tragedies share is that people are trying to do too many things at once and forget to do something they should do. It's strange, but somehow, over time, the image of the modern human has become one of a multitasker. We think we can, so we think we should. Kids studying while texting, listening to music, or watching television. Adults driving while talking on the phone, eating, applying makeup, or even shaving. Doing something in one room while talking to someone in the next. Smartphones in hands before napkins hit laps. It's not that we have too little time to do all the things we need to do. It's that we feel the need to do too many things in the time we have. So we double and triple up in the hope of getting everything done. And then there's work. The modern office is a carnival of distracting, multitasking demands. While you diligently try to complete a project, someone has a coughing fit in a nearby cubicle and asks if you have a lozenge. The office paging system continually calls out messages that anyone within earshot of an intercom hears. You're alerted around the clock to new emails arriving in your inbox, while your social media news feed keeps trying to catch your eye, and your cell phone intermittently vibrates on the desk to the tune of a new text. A stack of unopened mail and piles of unfinished work sit within sight as people keep swinging by your desk all day to ask you questions. Distraction, disturbance, disruption. Staying on task is exhausting. Researchers estimate that workers are interrupted every 11 minutes and then spend almost a third of their day recovering from these distractions. And yet, amid all of this, we still assume we can rise above it and do what has to be done within our deadlines. But we're fooling ourselves. Multitasking is a scam. Poet laureate Billy Collins summed it up well when he said, "We call it multitasking, which makes it sound like an ability to do lots and lots of things at the same time. A Buddhist would call this monkey mind. We think we're mastering multitasking, but we're just driving ourselves bananas."
Juggling is an illusion.
We come by it naturally, with an average of 4,000 thoughts a day flying in and flying out of our heads. It's easy to see why we try to multitask. If a change in thought every 14 seconds is an invitation to change direction, then it's rather obvious we are continually tempted to try to do too much at once. While doing one thing, we're only seconds away from thinking of something else we could do.